She is still a prostitute. She is selling false stories now for money about me.
Do you have any concern calling her a prostitute when she was victimized at such a young age by this wealthy man?
She was not victimized. She made her own decisions in life.
And at the age of 15, some would say that's a little young and that she was taken advantage of.
When you were negotiating that deal, did you say the word whore so many times you forgot the meaning?
No, I didn't use that term. And I would never use that term to describe a young woman. I just laid out the facts. I chose to become a defense attorney because I like to defend the underdog. And I don't like supporting the government. I like challenging the government.
Man, I hope one day I can look at over 100 accusers and someone worth hundreds of millions of dollars and see that the rich pedophile is the underdog.
Fight the power!
Now, Jeffrey Epstein owned an island in the Caribbean called Little St. James. Have you ever been there? And if so, don't you hate it when Prince Andrew's ass knocks over your drink?
Well, my wife, my daughter, and I, she was about, I don't know, 7 or something. When Jeffrey Epstein first bought the island, he flew a private plane. We were vacationing in Guadeloupe or Martinique, I forget. And he flew us to the island for one day to see the new island. Nobody was on the island. And we met there with a professor at Harvard Law School.
And his really?
Wife and my wife and my daughter. We spent one day there. There were no young people there. There were no girls. There were no women.
That's a big relief you weren't there during Epstein's 20-year alleged pedophile phase.
No, I never was in any area where Epstein was, where there were ever any young people or any misconduct that I ever saw. The same is true, again, president of Harvard, president of the United States.
Well, that's a convincing defense. Nothing could have happened, Ma. Bill Clinton was there.
Do you have trouble sleeping because you know Jeffrey Epstein's tapes are out there somewhere and could instantly destroy all you hold dear?
My greatest wish is that Jeffrey Epstein took tapes of everything, because that would prove conclusively that I was not on any of the tapes.
Now, Alan, we're doing a sponsor feature.
He has to read the sponsor.
Then reach for Pleasant Dreams Natural Sleep Aid, because these days nothing just disappears. Now, the alleged victims say that they gave massages at Epstein's residences that turned into abuse. You said that you've only received one massage at Epstein's residence.
My wife had a massage. I had a massage. They were therapeutic massages. I kept my shorts on. Yes, I'm not a big massage person. As I said, my wife had a massage. I had a massage. That was routine. When you went to Epstein's places, he offered massages. And obviously, when he had them, they were not just massages.
How you know it was routine?
People like me and my wife, they were therapeutic. Let me put it very clearly. You have no constitutional right to endanger the public and spread a disease, even if you disagree. You have no right not to be vaccinated. You have no right not to wear a mask. You have no right to open up your business.
Wait, can I stop you? No right to
not
to be vaccinated, meaning if they decide you have to be vaccinated, we have to be vaccinated?
Absolutely. And if you refuse to be vaccinated, the state has the power to literally take you to a doctor's office and plunge a needle into your arm.
I believe if government were to now say, we just made a finding that there's a new virus and everyone should do X, Y, and Z, the amount of compliance with X, Y, and Z would be much, much lower than it was at the beginning of COVID, because people do not trust the government.